artificial intelligence and customer service are two of the hottest topics out there today, but there's a lot of misunderstanding about what artificial intelligence is when it comes to customer service, as well as what you should do about it today as a contact center leader. So I want to talk about a few things today. The first is just what is AI in the customer service realm and what are others like you doing about it today? Second is what should you be thinking about doing to get the most out of AI for your contact center? And third, what's the future look like for AI in customer service? What decisions can you make today that might help with that? So first, let's talk about what artificial intelligence is and how it relates to the contact center, as well as what your peers out there are applying in the contact center today for artificial intelligence. So first off, as a marketer, I'm partially guilty for creating a lot of the hype out there about AI. So let's talk about what AI is and how it's different from other technologies you might be using today. So first off, AI, I think, if you boil it down, has two simple components that are different from most software out there. First, it's conversational. So it's not about typing in or selecting pre-structured answers or responses. The conversational bot or the chat bot can understand a customer in their natural language and reply back like a person. The second is it's self-learning. So it's not about just prescriptively saying, like a knowledge base, if they ask this, give them that answer, but it improves over time. So now we've kind of got a baseline definition of what AI is. How are people like you as contact center leaders applying that today? So, you know, in terms of why people are looking at applying AI, it should be no surprise that getting faster responses for their customers and saving money are the two top items on the list. There's a third really important reason people are applying AI today, which shouldn't be discounted, which is that there's a fear that your competition is applying it and giving them a competitive advantage over your company. Of course, that also is probably why your boss or your boss's boss has been asking you about what your AI strategy is. The good news is there are a few easy places to start in terms of applying AI in your contact center. Now, if you look at where to start, self-service is a great place to apply AI. That's probably where most people are thinking of AI in the contact center. You're able to provide voice bots or chat bots to help automate common issues and be able to save valuable agent time for the more complex ones. When we look at data, it says about anywhere from a quarter to a third of contact centers have started some level of pilot. That number is mostly geared towards the larger companies. So if you're a small or mid-sized company, this means you've got an excellent opportunity to really take the lead over your competition by doing some AI projects right now. So now let's talk about where you can get some of the biggest bang for the buck today with AI in your contact center. We've talked about self-service being an obvious place to start with AI chatbots and voice bots, but one of the important things to note is that the containment rates for self-service functions staying inside the AI chatbot or voice bot are still relatively low today. So you're going to need to plan how to elevate that self-service bot conversation to a live agent. So making sure you can elevate that quickly and maybe even have that bot help the agent handle one or more interactions simultaneously through a chat or messaging application is a really great way to get a fast ROI because you're helping to reduce those conversations for live agents, but also able to handle those customer conversations that a bot can't quite handle yet today. The second place to look for savings in AI today is really in streamlining workforce management or routing. So you can use a lot of AI algorithms to get to the best agent based on personality fits and other skills, as well as being able to really optimize your intraday staffing levels of WFM. Finally, let's talk about what AI holds for the future of the contact center and customer service. So one of the most interesting things is as you talk about AI not just being a self-service option, but also blending and working alongside agents, whether it be in workforce planning or handling customer interactions, is that agents and bots don't become an either-or competition in terms of bots eating an agent's job, but bots really become another part of your workforce, or really become a digital virtual workforce. In this way, you need to start thinking about how do you plan for your bots like your agents. What are they good at? What do they have proficiencies at? And how can you actually evaluate as your bots get better what type of interactions you might want them to take? Also, how do you coach bots like you coach people? Right? People are usually coached in one-on-one interactions with their supervisors. For bots, it's about data, right? So thinking about coaching, raising the proficiency level of bots, then gets into a third and really interesting area of managing bots and human agents together, which is how do you actually balance your scheduling and your routing when an agent or a bot, either one, might be just as good at handling interaction. So I think to recap, think about what your goals are. Start with some low-hanging fruit in self-service, but also make sure you don't stay in self-service or look at other applications where you can get benefits like routing, workforce management, and helping the bots do after-call work with agents. And finally, start thinking about what a bot plus agent workforce might look like and how those two can work together in the future.